Hey, Miri!
Huh?
I just bought this cool shirt for myself.
What are you wearing?
I thought you were very knowledgeable about fashion. This is a nice formal shirt.
My friend, you look like you are a barcode. Yuck!
You mean this isn't a nice shirt?
No, it's not. We are going back at the shop at once and exchange this with something nice.
Okay. I thought this looked nice. Anyways, let's go.
Huh?
There we have to go!
What can I do for you, sir?
My friend here purchased this shirt some time ago. We would like to exchange it.
No problem, sir. Just let me check the label. Here you are, sir. This shirt costs 600 rupees. You can exchange it with the shirt of the same amount or greater.
How did that mouse come to know about that price of this? Just by these lines? These lines look almost like a pattern on this shirt. Is this the code you accused me of looking like?
Yes, Didi. That's what I meant. The code is called a barcode.
Barcode? What is that?
Well, as you can see, the code is made of lines, which vary in thickness. This line pattern is unique in nature, and it can be assigned to any object. In this case, it's assigned to this shirt.
Okay, but how does that tell you about the price of this shirt?
The information like price, manufacturer's name, date of manufacturing, etc. about the shirt is already linked to the barcode on the computer.
So he used that machine to read the code?
What he used was the device called a barcode reader. It's a scanner which scans the code and recognizes it. Then it sends that information to the computer, which interprets the code and shows the information.
That's really fascinating.
In order to remove this problem, the store uses a system called UPC or Universal Product Code.
Let me guess, the product details and their assigned codes are universally registered.
Yes, Thierry. It is a very convenient method to maintain stocks, sales records, etc.
Miri, do tell me more about this technology.
Then I should tell you that there are other such types of technologies which are used for various other purposes.
Are you telling me that this isn't the only use of this technology?
No, not at all. There are various other fields where similar interpretations prove to be more efficient. For example, banks use magnetic ink character recognition, MICR. They use it for reading check numbers and deposit slips. It allows banks to efficiently maintain account records.
That's great!
There is another extraordinary technology called OCR or optical character recognition.
Hey, I know about that one. They use a scanner to scan and recognize printed letters or digits and convert them into computer readable format. But do you know about OMR?
You are just making it up to make me look dumb.
Why would I do that? There really is such a thing called OMR. It is the short form of optical mark recognition. This technology senses whether the mark, typically a pencil mark, is present or not. It's mostly used for checking multiple choice test answers.
Wow! How did you come to know about these?
Same way as you know about barcode, you too must have looked about it over the internet.